Hello, everybody. Welcome to a late episode of Sunday Showcase. Sorry about that. There was just a lot of stuff going on, a lot of snow shoveling, doing other things, celebrating National Ninja Day. And that's a game that we're going to be playing, or I'm going to be playing today for Sunday Showcase. There were some votes on the Sunday Showcase poll. Thank you all for voting. But I think I'm going to do a change up how... when I'll accept, like, the votes that happen in the Sunday Showcase poll, like, maybe if, like, once I get 10 votes or something, something conclusive, then, like, I'll take the suggestions. So, let's go play a ninja game to celebrate National Ninja Day. That was yesterday, at the time of, this gets uploaded on Monday. Alright, so we're playing on my Sega Genesis, because we're going to be playing Shadow Dancer, which I did do a play yesterday with D. Tyson for National Ninja Day. I would wear a little mask, but, you know, you're focusing on the game and not so much me. The Secret of Shinobi. It had a little E there for a second. Shadow Dancer. Which is supposed to be the second game in the Shinobi series, but I don't know. So this goes back to the arcade style of the first game, I believe. And this game is pretty neat, if a bit, difficult. You die very easily in this game, so... I'm gonna play only a few stages in this, game. You got your ninja, you got your dog, you also got special attacks you can do. The goal of the game is to rescue everybody and then make it to the end of the, level. That actually, from what I've seen, does not actually hurt you. Take that, Conker. That guy can't hurt you because I'm on a different plane. You jump onto, like, several different planes. Okay. Slash. If you're close enough to an enemy, you will not, you will, do it as a sword attack instead. Oh, and every time you save a woman hostage, for some reason that gives you a power-up, but everyone else does not give you power-up, which, I wonder what else he gets up when that happens. Yeah, they think they're so clever with that. You get points, which... presumably we'll give you a life up, but usually you get the life up from the bonus stage. You know, despite being on my Sega Genesis, like, my model of it, the quality is actually still pretty good. Oh! Once you're power up, you can shoot through the shield gun, which is, nice. Ah, it was a secret! I did not know that, actually. Oh, that was close, because you can only take one hit in this game. Why is that guy up there? Curious. Okay, now we come to the first boss of the game. He is pretty difficult if you don't know how to fight him, but overall, I think you should have no problems. You don't get to keep your power-ups with you, which sucks. He shoots a fireball that you can just duck. I thought you had to jump over it, but no, you don't have to. I hate that. You cannot. That is so bullshit. Oh, you can't really run. Oh. So, when you're stuck in those situations, you're kind of fucked. Oh, that's funny. Oh god. Yeah, ninja teabag! Bitch! Alright, now comes a little bonus stage where you get a bunch of lives if... or you get up to 3 lives if you hit all the ninjas. So I'm gonna stick over here to the side. This is the little trick to the... to getting all the ninjas. It's not guaranteed, but... well, it's mostly guaranteed as long as you just keep mashing. Oh, I can't believe I hit that. Because when they get that high, you can't really hit them. Just keep mashing, stay on the side. Because if you stay in the middle, they're much, much more difficult to hit, and it gets a lot more confusing. There we go, we got a bunch of lives. You have to get at least 48 hits on the ninjas to get a life. I guess we can do stage 2. Or maybe up to stage 3. Who knows? I'm beating it pretty fast. And it is pretty crucial that you get lives. Also, always watch your back. Because they love doing the thing where it's like, oh, an enemy comes up from behind. Save the hostages, guys. Don't give you anything. They don't give you anything for saving them, but the ladies do. Alright, this guy likes to go low. Oh, crap. That was kind of...
That wasn't a good showcase of that. I should have just went up and kicked him in the face. You don't want to lose your power up because it's a really, really good advantage. You can bump into enemies, so touching them isn't necessarily death. It's only when they hit you that it counts as a death. I'll wait till he reloads. Hey, buddy. Oh, I skipped the point system. Well, but that's okay. Doesn't seem to be doing much. Ah. Come on. I could go up and kick them in the face, but since I can only take one hit, unlike the other Shinobi games where you actually have multiple, where you actually have a life bar, and unlike the other Shinobis, you actually have an unlimited amount of, Oh, geez. See that? I almost got killed there. Unlike the other Shinobis where you have limited shurikens that you can use. Thank God I was quick enough. Obviously, the melee is a lot stronger, but obviously you also risk the chance of getting killed, but, you know, just calm down, don't panic, and be methodical about this. Oh, that was much easier than I thought. Not that it was difficult. This game can be really easy if you, don't die. Oh, this guy. I remember this guy. He's hard to hit, that was the deal. Yeah, that's why. Yep, you just have to stay far away and you won't get hurt. Like, really far away. Oh, there we go. He's also tricky to hit. Oh, rarely do I. Oh. If only your stupid ninja can run. But he's a ninja! How is he not. How can't he not run? Oh, that was a. Oh, you can't hit him twice. This guy's not hard, but he can be an asshole. Because the opportunity that you get to hit him is, not that often. Oh, okay, it's only the hands that hurt you. That's good to know. He thinks he can hand me down. There we go. I teabag you, but you're too high. On the wall. Alright, yeah, I got it. I try not to stick too far to the wall, but just enough to that you're in this position. You can only throw, like, about 3 ninja stars, or, I don't know how many stars you can throw, but there's a limit to how many you can throw on screen at a time. Oh, we missed one. We'll only get two one-ups if I get everyone else. There we go, 2 one-ups. Still nice, but could be better. Well, I guess this is the last round I'm going to showcase off. This one is probably, starts to get tricky. Man, what kind of gun only holds 3 bullets? Whatever it is, it's enough to kill a shinobi. Yeah, I did that to keep stunning him. Let's go damn low. But I'm like, ah, low, he doesn't get to live. I had to go through this level quite a lot when I was showcasing it. Lady was trying to do the bird. Gotta be careful and take it slowly. Yeah, in the face. Yeah, I obviously knew that because I played it before. Like I said, you really want the power up because it just it bypasses everyone's defenses. You can't get that unless you go on top, so. Oh, that was close. Like I said, you can bump into them, but you can't do anything else. And it seems like. Oh! It seems you were supposed to be right here. Let's see if I can get this guy. Oh! Alright, we got him. Now we just gotta be careful. We don't have to fight all of them, we just gotta go! I don't think you can do a pacifist run of this. I'm not saying it's impossible, but it will be very difficult, and this part is pretty difficult in itself, too. I've died here a lot. I've lost a lot of lives, and you do get continues in this game. There he goes. And of course, jumping over the bullet, where the bullet lands, will obviously keep you safe. By the way, there's no checkpoints. And I may be stuck here. There's obviously a strategy that I could use the ninja bomb, but it's kind of a waste. Not that you get to save it, because you get a refill every level. Come on. Well, it's obvious where they're gonna pop up. It's just every time there's a little board. I don't think your dog is very helpful here. So you can't double jump like in the Shinobi games. So we're almost there. We just need to. Oh! That went a lot better than I thought. Usually I die like about 6 times there. Shinobi bonus. Did I get. Is it because I got everyone? Yeah, and this boss is a little crazy. Yeah, also keep the boss on screen so you can see where they are. Okay, you can bump into the boss. I do like the fact that it's only if they attack you it kills you, which even some games don't do that. That's a really annoying time. Please don't let me die and continue. Oh, wait, actually, if you continue, you don't have to start all over. That's the nice thing. I'm sure there's some easy strategy that I'm just not doing. I think being extra close might help. Or not. Just be careful and patient. This fight is all patience. She just had to dodge it, or he. Remember, this is crazy. This is the crazy fashion back then. I think being close does help, because your ninja stars don't have to travel as far. Son of a bitch! Oh yeah, you're also on a time limit too, so can't wait that long. That's weird, she didn't let me hit. Gotta start all over again, just... Wait till the thing sparks! Stop it! Right in front of the Statue of Liberty, too, by the way. On Spark. By the All Spark. Can't hit her from below. Oh, almost got her. I guess when she throws the thing over, you can hit her there. And I just noticed she had the bouncies on her, so. Yeah. Oh, we'll do one more bonus stage. I'll get you all. I guess not. You might occasionally want to switch sides. How many was that I missed? Two? Oh, at least I showed you like how many hits you at least need to throw, so... At the very least, there was that. Oh, God. The cave level. This part, they go all light and dark on you. And that's where my game pretty much ended. So, that was the... So, this is this week's late Sunday showcase. I apologize for the lateness, as I mentioned before. And that was Shadow Dancer on the Sega Genesis, the second game in the Shinobi series that I'm pretty sure I'll have to ask my ninja friend about it, which is Benny Ninjas, and you should go check out his channel as he also celebrated National Ninja Day. And, well, it's too late to do it now, but hey, late National Ninja Day, right? So. With that said, I hope you enjoyed this episode of Sunday Showcase, and if you'd like to have an influence and affect the direction that Sunday Showcase goes, go to my site, LazyWorksCreations.com, vote in the Sunday Showcase poll, and the link will be in the description and such. I don't know if you guys check the link in the description, because I usually put it, and if not, I tend to forget. Thanks for watching Sunday Showcase. This is WizWorld 100, you're the viewers, and I'm the showcaser, so... Stay tuned for more. I am working on reviews, so just need to get a good time when Fuckface Furnace is not fucking my audio in the face. See ya!